coming to you live from the UTPA Fieldhouse and the three-time All-American City of Edinburgh. This is Bronx basketball. Tonight, the Bronx play their first ever Western Athletic Conference contest when they host the Grand Canyon University Antelopes. Good evening again, everybody. Jonah Goldberg riding with you courtside. UTPA women's basketball embarking on a little bit of history. Now, they're not the first Bronx team to play a WAC contest. That's been done. It was done in volleyball, and it was done across country. But the first basketball team, the men play Grand Canyon. They start about an hour on the road after we do. So the first ever WAC home game is tonight, and it's about, 13 and a half minutes away. And it's the first game with a lot of significance. This is the first time since February 28, 1998. Or check, 1998, that the Bronx are competing in a conference game in an automatic qualifier conference. And what that means is that game, that 1998 I referred to, was a Sun Belt conference game. Well, then the Bronx went independent for a few years, and they were the Great West Conference, which didn't have an auto bid to the NCAA tournament. So you come in this year, and now the Bronx have a chance at that. They have a chance to put themselves in position, and they've played one season so far. They played the non-conference schedule to try and help get themselves ready. Now is the conference schedule. Riped with meaning, because you can look at it two ways. On the one hand, you spend this whole schedule learning about your opponents and playing for seeding in the conference tournament. But remember, if you win the regular season conference championship, you clinch a playoff spot. At worst, the Bronx will be guaranteed a WNIT bid if they win the conference title and then don't win the tournament title. And then, of course, you're playing for the seeding, because once you get to the conference tournament, it's a three-day sprint to see who's going to make it to the NCAA tournament. It's a long time coming for UTPA, that is for sure. And they are looking very forward to this day, to this return to the national stage. They take on Grand Canyon in a meaningful conference contest. For Grand Canyon, well, it's also their first ever WAC game, but it's a little different. This is their first year of a four-year transition from Division II to Division I. They were contenders in Division II, one of the top teams in Division II. And now that has carried over to the Division I level. Grand Canyon has exploded on the scene to the tune of an 11-2 record, including an overtime win over North Texas, a two-point loss to UCLA, win over Nevada, and a win over Hawaii. They went 6-0 in December after starting off their first year D1 5-0. Their other loss, by the way, was to Mississippi State, and it was only by 9. So a team that's ripe with talent. They have a number of Division I transfers who have stepped up big. And it should be a very interesting contest tonight at the UTPA Fieldhouse in the first conference game of the year. We'll take a timeout coming up on Bronx Pregame. It's Coach's Corner. I'll chat with Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell. This is Bronx Basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room. Okay.
It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Coach, what's the preparation been like entering that first conference game?
Well, I tell you, we're facing a very good team in Grand Canyon State. They bring a lot to the table. They're good inside, they're good outside. We're going to try to mix it up. We're going to try a few little smoke and mirrors. We're going to try a little bit of everything to try to confuse them. But the main thing is we got to play hard-nosed defense, and we got to rebound. And we got to rebound with the focus.
What can you tell us about Grand Canyon?
Grand Canyon, a great shooter from the outside. They got the best player in the conference, Judy Jones. She's a three player, slash two player, gets it to the rim. But they finish good at the rim, but they shoot extremely well. And that's something that we're going to see in the WAC a lot. There's a lot of great shooters.
Any New Year's resolutions?
Any New Year's resolutions is I just want to make sure that we bring it every day. I try to bring it every day for this program, but I'm going to bring it not only for this program, for my team, for everybody in our athletic administration, but I also want to bring it to the Valley. Valley deserves a WAC conference, and we're going to try to make it a great one.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the big dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. Countdown to the start of tonight's WAC opener to the UTPA Bronx and the Grand Canyon University Cantaloupes. Time to take a look at the WAC standings. Well, because it's the day of the WAC opener, everybody has bagels in the columns. Doesn't mean there aren't a couple teams streaking. Seattle won their last seven WAC games last season. New Mexico State won their last two. Idaho lost their last one. Now, in the non-conference, Grand Canyon led the way with an 8.46 winning percentage. They went 11-2. Includes 5-0 at home, 3-0 on the road. Their only two losses at neutral sites. Idaho, 7-7. UTPA with the third best non-conference record at 6-7. Bakersfield went 5-6. Seattle went 5-8. Kansas City 4-9. New Mexico State 3-10. Utah Valley 3-10. And Chicago State 2-10. There is one remaining non-conference game. It's tonight. Bakersfield is at Cal State Northridge. But other than that, it's all conference play from here on out. Kind of wacky, huh? Oh, you knew I had to say it eventually, right? Well, we're going to take one more time out. When we come back, we're going to have your starting lineups, and we're going to have your opening tip. This is Bronx Basketball. Welcome to the WAC.
Brave and bold, silver and gold.
We're on a mission. Aggie up.
Bronx country just got a whole lot bigger.
Mighty Wolverines of UVU.
Join the herd. Lopes up.
Bold moves, big season, grew up.
We are the new gold standard.
We will be champions.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tax Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tax cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tax Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Well, if the sound you hear is the Who singing Who Are You, it must be time to introduce the starting lineups here at the UTPA Fieldhouse for the WAC opener between the UTPA Bronx and the Grand Canyon University Antelopes. We will start with the visiting Lopes. They are using a different starting lineup than they did in the last game. Part of that due to a return to the lineup. We'll start in the backcourt at the point guard position, a 5'7 junior out of Mission Viejo, California, number 20, Caitlin Peterson. At shooting guard, a 5'8 freshman out of Albuquerque, New Mexico. Number 24, Estrella Reed. At small forward, a 5'10 senior out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Number 45, Deanna Daniels. At power forward, returning to the lineup, a 6-foot senior out of Gilbert, Arizona. Number 44, Jenna Pearson. And at center, a 6'4 senior out of San Diego, California. Number 50, Asha McDonald. Head coach of the Antelopes is Trent May in season number 7. The associate head coach is Corey Cole, and the assistant coaches are Aaron Scholes and Miley Curry. The Lopes enter this game with a record of 11-2. They've won 6 straight. They are 3-0 on the road and 7-2 away from home. Include neutral sites in that. As for those hosts, UTPA Bronx, they've got a change in the lineup as well. Starting at the point guard position, a 5'7 junior out of Wichita, Kansas, number 14, Teandria Nolan. At shooting guard, a 5'6 junior out of Gardner, Kansas, number 3, Tonisha Walker. At small forward, a 5'8 freshman out of Copperas Cove, number 11, Shante Goff. At power forward, a 5'8 junior out of Chicago, Illinois, number 1, Jasmine Thompson. And at center, a 5'11 junior out of Midwest City, Oklahoma, number 20, Sherelle Price. The head coach of the Bronx in his first season is Mr. Larry Tidwell. The associate head coach is John Ishii, and the assistant coaches are Anthony Anderson and Hannah Burleson. The Bronx enter this game with a record of 6-7. They've lost 3 in a row. But the Bronx play well at home. They're 3-1 here at the cozy confines of the UTPA Fieldhouse. The officials for tonight's WAC match, Peter Contreras, Marlon Ramsey, and Effie Salas. The Lopes in their road black tops and bottoms with purple numbers on the front and on the back in white trim. Purple letters GCU for Grand Canyon University on the front, also in white trim. They'll be moving from left to right. The Rocks in their home white tops and bottoms with the green numerals on the front and on the back in orange trim. And the letters spelling out Bronx across the front above the number. They have orange striping down the sides. Jasmine Thompson is going to take the tip and very much outsized as Grand Canyon wins it with McDonald. And we're underway. Moving from left to right across your computer screen. Or if you've got one of those fancy dancy Apple TVs, perhaps even your television screen. Reed with the basketball. Ball comes down low to McDonald, lays it up and in. And the Lopes strike first. It's 2-0. Price launches a quick three. It doesn't fall. Rebound Grand Canyon. Bronx stay with Grand Canyon the whole way. Poke out of bounds would remain Grand Canyon balls. It's off Nolan. 38 seconds gone by. And Grand Canyon up 2-0. First whack game for either of these teams. Pearson. Now it's Peterson. Ball comes down low to the baseline. Down low again underneath the basket. McDonald misses on the layup, gets her on a rebound, puts it in, and she is going to be a mismatch problem all night long. It's 4-0 Grand Canyon. You can just see it out on the court. At 6'4", McDonald far and away the tallest player on the court or on either of these teams. The next tallest player on Grand Canyon is 6'2", Tori Morris, who also plays center. Foul on Pearson. Tallest player on the Bronx who's available, well, the tallest player, either way, is 6'2", Taylor Cyphers. So even she would have a 2-inch size disadvantage, but you'll be interesting to see if they end up putting her in as Thompson nails a three from the left wing. Bronx within one, it's 4-3. I think it's going to depend how these next few possessions go with McDonald, but if I'm Grand Canyon, I'm just throwing it down there. The Lopes turn it over, Bronx ball, and they can take the lead with the basket here. Nolan, Thompson, towards the basket, left wing Price. Price into the lane, throws it up and in. Jarrell Price with the basket. And the Bronx take the lead, it's 5-4. Reed, pass down low, comes out to the right wing. That's Pearson for three, no good. Rebound pulled in by Thompson, and she'll push the ball up the court. Pass the right corner, Walker. Up top to Price, thinks about it, instead goes left wing Goff. Goff going to the basket, gets fouled. And they award the continuation, so free throws for Goff. August Touchard in for GCU. Jenna Pearson takes a seat. And Shante Goff goes to the line for a couple of free throws. First one rattles in. Goff, a 63% free throw shooter this season. Bronx's team are also at 63%. Hits them both. It's a 7-0 run. The Bronx leads 7-4. Full court pressure for UTPA. Ball gets up the court to Touchard. Touchard matched up with Goff. Moves left, trying to find space. Goff sticking with her. Ball down low and knocked away out of bounds by Walker. Nice piece of defense there to keep the ball out of McDonald's hands underneath the basket. Remains Lopes' ball, but with just 7 on the shot clock. See if the Bronx forces up the turnover here. They look for McDonald, but it's tipped by Walker into the hands of Nolan, and here come the Bronx. Thompson coming strong to the basket. Good on the foul! Thompson's got... Oh, they called it an offensive foul. So it becomes Lopes' ball. Pearson passes the ball low to Daniels. Daniels, right block. There's the left wing. There's a three ball on the way. No good. And the rebound taken in by McDonald, who passes it back out. Peterson, pass errant, out of bounds, and it's Bronx ball. The Bronx bench explodes in excitement. A lot of energy early. Can you blame them? Nolan. It's over to Price. Price tries to put it up, and that's swatted by McDonald. Demands a two shard, and back we go the other way. And that size of McDonald paying dividends on both ends so far. She's got all four of Grand Canyon's points, and now she's got a block as well. Near steal, Grand Canyon retains. Comes to the left corner. Missed by Reed. Rebound, Bronx. 4 minutes gone by. Bronx by three on a 7-0 run. Goff for three. Got it! It's a 10-0 run. Shante Goff nails the triple. And the Bronx lead 10-4. And Caitlin Peterson with the pull-up breaks the run. It's 10-6. Nolan tried to pass it for Walker, but that one's going to hit the press row and become Grand Canyon ball when we return. 15-18 to play in the opening half of the Bronx with a 10-6 lead. This is Bronx basketball.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the Big Dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. 15-18 to play in the opening half. The Bronx out to a 10-6 lead. Grand Canyon got the first 4 points of the game. Back-to-back layups by McDonald. The Bronx responded with a 10-0 run, capped by a Shante Goff three-pointer and started by Jasmine Thompson three-pointer. But a Peterson floater. Broke the run. It's 10-6. And right underneath, an attempt at a bank shot goes in for Reed. And the Bronx lead is 10-8. Price, left alone at the top, launches the three, misses wide left. The rebound pulled in by Goff. She passes it out. Nolan will start up a new play. Pass left wing, Thompson. Bronx haven't made a sub yet as Thompson hops into the lane, tries the shot, banks it in. Jasmine Thompson puts the Bronx up 12-8. Almost 6 minutes gone by. Pass, stole it. Here comes Daniels up the court. One-on-one with Nolan, misses the layup. Rebound Thompson, misses it ahead to Nolan. Bronx coming in 3-on-2. Price underneath, throws it up, misses. Rebound tipped around, goes out, and it's off of the Bronx. It's Grand Canyon ball. 13:50 to play, opening half.
In for the Bronx is number 25, Shantae Wright, as well as number 2, Alexandria Hill.
Jose Wright and Alexandria Hill are in. Tandria Nolan and Sherelle Price take a seat. It's interesting to see how these lineups have progressed. The Bronx playing a relatively small lineup. Certainly smaller than Grand Canyon's. An air ball, a rebound by Goff. So it's always interesting when you have those matches, a block of a three-point shot. Look at that. Touchard got right in front of Goff. Knocked it out. Remains Bronx ball, 23 on the shot clock. It's always interesting which team will have to adjust. Will it be the size mismatches causing problems for the smaller team, or will it be the speed of the smaller team causing problems for the bigger team? I mean, in the first two possessions of the game, it certainly looked like the Bronx were going to be the team that we're going to have to adjust, but after that 10-0 run, I'm not so sure anymore, because you know what? Look who's adjusted. Look at the lineup right now. Grand Canyon adjusted. They went smaller. And that's the key. If you can make the other team adjust to the lineup that you have out there rather than having to adjust to theirs, that's always a good thing. There's the turnaround jumper, falls in for Jasmine Grayson. Transfer from Cal State Fullerton. Give you an idea, you know, if Caitlin Peterson, who went to both Northridge and Gonzaga. You have Courtney Hayes from Louisiana Tech, Erica Pascal from Texas Arlington, Justine Johnson from Weber State. So a few Division I transfers on this Grand Canyon squad, and they've played well. Ball down low, batted away, stolen by the Bronx. Here they come, they've got numbers, they hurry. 5-on-3 developing. Hill going straight to the rack, gets fouled.
Personal foul was on number 20, Peterson
picks up her first foul. It's 3 on Grand Canyon, and Hill, who's a perfect 4-for-4 from the line this season, makes the first one. It's a 3-point advantage. Hill hits the second. 6-for-6 from the line this year. The Bronx lead 14-10. Just about 8 minutes gone by. Ball comes down low for Grand Canyon. Grayson gets fouled. And we hit immediate timeout. 11:58 to play. Bronx lead 14-10. This is Bronx basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tack Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. Bronx with a 14-10 lead over the Grand Canyon Antelopes with 11:58 to play. Grayson at the line shooting two. She's 3-for-8 from the line this season. Hits the first. Grand Canyon is ranked 25th in the nation in the collegeinsider.com mid-majors poll, which is a poll that only includes mid-major conferences like the WAC. Give you an idea of how good they've been. Now they turn it over here. It's already their sixth turnover of the game. Goff along the baseline. The jumper goes in. And the Bronx lead is 16-11. Guichard. Pass over to Madison Craig. Ball comes down low and a blocking foul called on Goff, whose arms were straight up in the air. Coach Tidwell has a look of disbelief. Actually, it's on Thompson. It's two on Thompson. So Thompson will take a seat. Raquel Preston comes in. 11:05 to go in the first. Touchard and Grayson take a seat. McDonald is in. And Peterson's back in for Grand Canyon. Goff's got it at the top. Hill, left wing. Ball cycles around. Comes down low. Preston hits the jumper. And the Bronx lead 18-13. Drive to the lane leads to a basket for Grand Canyon, and it's a one possession game, 18-15. Hill pass left wing Goff. Moves over to her right, back to her left. Over to Walker, now the left corner. That's right, who airballs the three. Preston had it, but it gets knocked out of her hands and out of bounds. The remain Bronx ball with 12 on the shot clock, 10-11 game clock, 18-15 Bronx. Goff is the ball on the left wing. Pops from the lane. Rounded out. Rebound right. He throws it up and gets fouled. Wright's going to the line.
That was the right move.
That's one on McDonald. Four on Grand Canyon. Wright 8 of 15 from the line this season. She hits the first. And it's a two-possession game. DeAndre Nolan back in for the Bronx. Shante Goff gets a breather. Goff already with 7 points, leads all scores. Second shot falls in. It's 20 to 15 Bronx. Ooh. That's a foul on Tanisha Walker.
Her first team's foul.
Ball comes down low to Daniels. Misses. Over the back on the rebound. That's two on McDonald. Going to send McDonald back to the bench. Torrey Morris is in, the 6'2 freshman center out of Herndon, Virginia. Hill, pass left side, Nolan. Goes inside, Preston, outside, Hill for three. Goes in! Oh, you see a ball bounce around like that. It is nice to see it fall through the netting. 23-15. The Bronx lead is 8, and they're playing some great defense in the backcourt. How about this? Grand Canyon only has 1 second to get it across the half-court line. There's 21 on the shot clock, and they are still trying to inbound next to their own basket because of the Bronx full-court press. So they're going to go with the long inbounds, and it's picked off by Wright. Pass over to Nolan on the left wing, and the possession belongs to the Bronx. Up top to Hill, alone, an NBA three. Nailed it! 26-15 Bronx! Time out! Antelopes! Back-to-back threes for Alexandria Hill. The Bronx lead by 11. It's their largest lead of the game. They're on an 8-0 run over the last minute and a half. On the power of Wright's 2 free throws and Hill's 2 three-pointers. It's a 14-5 run over the last 4 minutes. During that time, the Bronx 4-7 from the field, 2-3 from behind the arc. Grand Canyon's 1-2. So it's not that they're not hitting their shots and not getting to shoot them. Bronx are playing great defense right now. Full court press, more trouble with it. And they'll call the foul. Erica Pascal fell to the floor trying to pass that ball off.
In for the Antelopes, number 10, August Touchard.
They call a foul on Hill. Bronx are at 6. There's the pull up, and it's good for Peterson. Bronx lead back in single figures. It's 26-17. Hill, a deep three. That one wouldn't go. If she had hit that, my goodness. I mean, she was 3 feet beyond the NBA arc. She can hit, though. She's got the range. And now Coach Tidwell calling for a timeout. 8.5 minutes remaining. And, you know, that extends into a media timeout because of the new rules this year, so we'll step aside.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put them somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tax Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tax cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tax Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. John Goldberg riding with you. 8.5 minutes to play. The Bronx lead 26-17. Bronx 4-8 from behind the arc. Lopes are 0-2. Difference in the game. Hill directing traffic at the top of the key. Pass right wing Goff. Goff to the baseline. Tries to pass it out but steps out of bounds. It's Lopes' ball. Bronx going full court press. It's been working pretty well. Peterson trying to get past Goff, races up the court. Now tries to dribble her way in, has the ball knocked loose, but it's picked up by Pascal. There's the shot from the left baseline, it's good. Peterson is now at 8 points to lead the Lopes. It's 26-19. Right, pulls up, doesn't go. There's a rebound, it goes out of bounds. Main Bronx ball. Sherelle Price is in, Shazay Wright is out. Goff, inbounds to Nolan. Throws it up, misses. A rebound by Daniels. And the Lopes have gotten the last 4 points on jumpers by Peterson. Touchard at the top. Has 10 on the shot clock. Comes towards the baseline with 7, passes it off. Daniels misfires, rebound Price. Hill up top to Price, the left wing Nolan. Bounce down low. Out of the reach of Preston, out of bounds, it's Lopes' ball.
Out of bounds. In for the Antelopes, number 24, Estrella Reed, and number 44, Janet Pearson. It is Antelopes basketball.
Yeah.
Peterson. Pass goes long to the baseline. That's Pascal with six. Now back up to Peterson. Tries an NBA three of her own. No good. And a rebound, Hill. Hill racing it towards the basket. Gets past her defender and lays it in. Alexandria Hill. Now she's been coming on lately, and tonight a seeming culmination. Having herself a ball game. Hill's got 10. 3 of 4 from the field. She also has 2 steals. A couple of NBA threes.
Personal foul is on number 44, Jenna Pearson, for the third, team 6. In for the Bronx, number 1, Jasmine Thompson, replacing number 24, Raquel Preston.
Traveling comes Grand Canyon ball with 5:52 to play.
Go defense!
Go defense! Out of bounds, it is Bronx basketball.
Coach Tidwell calls out the play. Goff with the basketball on the left wing. Goff comes in, gets fouled on the floor. Well, it's the 7th foul on Grand Canyon. So 1-1 coming up for Shante Goff.
At the line for the Bronx, number 11, Shante Goff.
Goff hits the first. And the second. Peterson. Touchard. Down low to Daniels. Bounces around, doesn't fall. Offensive rebound thrown up wildly by Morris. Bounces around and Daniels picks it up. Gives it to Peterson. Pass to the corner. That's Pascal who misses. Thompson the rebound with 5 minutes to go. The Bronx up 11 looking for more. Thompson wildly got it! And the foul! Except it's offensive, again. Thompson's second offensive foul of the game.
In for the Bronx is number 3, Tanisha Walker, replacing number 1, Jasmine Thompson. And in for the Antelopes, number 11, Madison Craig, replacing number
12, Erica Pascal. So still 30-19 with 4:45 to go. Touchard, Craig comes down low, Daniels. And another offensive foul. This one's against Grand Canyon. It's Bronx ball. That is the third basket today we've seen waved off due to an offensive foul. 2 have affected Thompson, now 1 here affecting Grand Canyon. Hill calls out the play, pass over to the right wing, Goff. Takes a deep 3. Doesn't go. I mean, that was 2 feet behind the NBA arc. We'll tie up underneath. They're going to call a jump ball. Possession arrow favors the Bronx. So it'll be Bronx balls. Raquel Preston checks in.
In for the Bronx is number 24, Raquel Preston. She replaces number 2, Alexandria Hill.
Price misses. Offensive board for Preston. Aimed for Goff. Missed and nearly hit our table of beat reporters. And we're up against our final media timeout of the half with 3:56 to play. Then the score 30-19 in favor of the Bronx. This is Bronx basketball.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the Big Dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Brave and bold, silver and gold.
We're on a mission. Aggie up.
Bronx country just got a whole lot bigger.
Mighty Wolverines at UVU.
Join the herd. Lopes up.
Bold moves, big season, grew up.
We are the new gold standard.
We will be champions.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
Back in the UTPA Fieldhouse, Jonah Goldberg riding with you. 3:48 to go in the Bronx. Up 30-19, make it 30-21. On that Daniels layup. Price for three, nails it!
3 points for Jarrell Price.
And it's a 12-point advantage for UTPA. There's a three from the right corner, it's good for Touchard. Bronx lead cut to nine. Nolan. Left wing Goff. Comes towards the hoop as the ball knocked away. Gets it back, fires it out to the right wing. There's Nolan for three, too strong. Rebound to Shard. Air ball, rebound for Nolan. And here she comes up the court. Bronx 5-on-4 right now. Goff alone for three. Off the iron. Offensive board for Preston. Sends it out to Walker up top to Goff, or Nolan rather. We'll start up the play. All the right wing to Goff, and it's off her fingertip. Picked up by Nolan. Now the left corner, Walker for three. No good. Strong side rebound, Grand Canyon. Greg on the right wing. 3-second violation against the Lopes. It's Bronx ball.
is Bronx basketball. In for the Bronx is number 2, Alexandria Hill.
Alexandria Hill up the court for UTPA. Hill launches a three, it's short. Lopes ball. Bronx applying a little pressure, not as much full court press as they were earlier. And there's the cutter, miss, rebound Goff. Goff with a head of steam, passes it out to Hill. Left corner, deep two, no good. Rebound, out of bounds. And it's Lopes basketball with a minute 12 left in the half. And score 33-24, Bronx. Daniels. Ball at the top, Peterson moves left, turns around, passes out to the right wing. Now the left wing, block on a three. Bronx ball. Hill, Price for three, got it. 36-24 Bronx. Peterson is 12 seconds on the clock. Moves left. It's heavy pressure, picked up her dribble. Pass, stolen. Walker, 3 seconds left. Walker throws it up. And she got fouled with 8/10 of a second left on the clock. Walker misses on the first.
At the line is number 3, Tanisha Walker.
Second shot's good. 37-24. And a half court heave. Misses wide right. We go into the half, and the Bronx have a 13-point lead over the 25th ranked team in mid-major basketball. How about that? Not a bad way to start your WAC opener. Bronx with a 13-point lead. The goal here, hey, maintain, expand, you know. We'll take a timeout. Coming up on Bronx for the half, we'll take a look at your first half stats. This is Bronx basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital at Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put them somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. The score at the half is 37-24 Bronx. What you're seeing right now is the bongo drums, Ken. You can't see the words because it's blocked by our score bug, but what's going on the video board right now? We've had a few people who've been very intensely into it. It's just been a lot of fun to watch. Oh, it just ended. It is among my favorite cams. I mean, anybody can do a flex cam or a dance cam or a kiss cam or a smile cam. We do all of them. But I love the bongo drums cam about as much as I love this camera angle we're getting right now. So let's show you some of the first half stats. We'll start with Grand Canyon. Leading the Lopes in scoring with 8 points, Caitlin Peterson on 4 of 6 shooting. 2 assists and a steal. After that, it's 4 points for Deanna Daniels, 4 rebounds, 2 assists and a steal. 4 points for Asha McDonald with 2 blocks and 2 rebounds. 3 points for August Touchard with 3 rebounds, an assist, a block, and a steal. 3 points for Jasmine Grayson with a steal. And 2 points for Estrella Reed.
Fans, Massage Envy, Office Furniture, KEI Institute, Renaissance Casa de Palmas.
The Lopes are 10 of 29 from the field. That is 34.5%. 1 of 8 from behind the arc. 3 for 4 from the line. 15 rebounds, 6 offensive. Compared to 23 and 10 by the Bronx. The Bronx have Alexandria Hill leading the way in scoring with 10 points. 3 of 6 shooting. 2 of 4 from behind the arc, 2 of 2 from the line with a rebound, an assist, and 2 steals. 9 points for Shante Goff on 2 of 5 shooting, 1 of 3 from behind the arc, 4 of 4 from the line. 3 rebounds, an assist, and a block. Eight points for Sherelle Price, 3 of 8 shooting, 2 of 5 from behind the arc. It's 5 points for Jasmine Thompson with 4 rebounds. 2 points, 4 rebounds, assist and a steal for Raquel Preston. 2 points for Shazay Wright with 2 boards and a steal. And a point and a rebound for Tanisha Walker. The Bronx, 11 of 30 from the field, that's 37%. 6 of 16 from behind the arc, 38%, and 9 of 10 from the line. Points in the paint. Lopes with 8, the Bronx with 2. Points off turnovers. The Bronx with 12 points off 12 Grand Canyon turnovers. The Lopes with 8 points off of 11 UTPA turnovers. Each team with 4 second chance points. UTPA's got 2 in the fast break. Lopes don't have any. 14 points off the Bronx bench, 6 off the Lopes. There's not been a tie. There has been 1 lead change. We'll give you all these numbers, but there's only 1. That matters. There are 2 that matter. 37-24, your score at the half. We'll take a timeout. When we come back, we're going to take a look around the WAC. This is Bronx Basketball.
Basketball.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the big dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Brave and bold, silver and gold.
We're on a mission. Aggie up.
Bronc country just got a whole lot bigger.
Mighty Wolverines at UVU.
Join the herd. Lopes up.
Bold moves, big season, Rue up.
We are the new gold standard.
We will be champions.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. The score at the half is 37-24 in favor of the UTPA Bronx. Time to take a look around the Western Athletic Conference. Two other WAC games on the slate and a non-conference game as well. The non-conference game, Bakersfield's at Cal State Northridge. That game doesn't start for another hour or so. The conference games both underway. They started at the same time as UPS. It's halftime at Chicago State, where Seattle has a 44-22 lead over Chicago State. In that game, Casey Sowell, preseason all-conference selection, leads Seattle with 12 points. Ward's got 10. Chicago State paced by Murphy, who has 6. The other game is at Kansas City. They just started up on the second half. And this game, kind of similar to the other one, Idaho has a 47-26 lead. Make it 47-28 now, a minute 12 into the second half. That's at Kansas City, so Kansas City, or rather Idaho and Seattle, two holdovers in the WAC. Taking out Kansas City was in the Summit last year, Chicago State in the Great West with the Bronx. And the holdovers are winning decisively. And Seattle and Idaho were picked to finish 1-2 in the conference this year. So no surprise that they're playing well. But of course here, Grand Canyon, who, although not picked to finish very high, received the first place vote in the media poll preseason. Well, they're down to the Bronx, 37-24. And again, it's worth mentioning, Grand Canyon is ranked 25th in the collegeinsider.com mid-major poll. And they're 11-2. And beat Nevada. And Hawaii. And North Texas. And lost to UCLA by 2. And the Bronx lead by 13 at the half. Take a time out. When we come back, we'll start up the second half. This is Bronx Basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. Start of the second half. Bronx lead by 13. It's Grand Canyon basketball out of the half break. Offensive board, and Peterson steps to her left. Lobs down low. It's McDonald. Puts it up and in. Deja vu all over again. 37-26. You're right. Remember, McDonald started off the game with a pair of layups. Underneath. But then was pretty much held in check for the rest of the half. Well, a good basket by Walker. Reed went down. So they stop play and give her a chance to get up. And Grand Canyon will inbound into the Bronx press, which drops back pretty quickly. Goff sticks with Peterson the entire way up the court. Lob comes to McDonald. She passes it out. Coming back down to McDonald, tipped out by Price. It'll remain Lopes ball. Three, nailed by Peterson. 3 points for Peterson. That's a 10-point game. Price. Works her way in, has her shot blocked from behind by McDonald. Here come the Lopes with Reed, who can't hold on. The Bronx steal it away. Lead pass up to Walker. Good in the foul. 41-29 Bronx. August Duchard picks up the foul. Raquel Preston in, Sherrell Price out for UTPA. Reed to the bench for Grand Canyon. As Craig checks in. Free throw good, 42-29. Craig launches a three and she nails it. That's a 10-point game again. See if the Bronx can answer once again. Nolan. It's the Goff. Goff biding her time with 11. Pass to Nolan. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Three, comes down low, and it's stolen by McDonald. And back we go the other way with Grand Canyon. Peterson. And offensive foul, it's Bronx basketball. 3 minutes gone in the first. Peterson just picked up her second foul. Bronx call for a timeout, extends to immediate timeout, so we'll step aside. The Bronx up 10, 17 minutes to go. This is Bronx basketball.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the Big Dance. Be there to see who will go home the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Back at the field house, where a Bronx miss turns into a Grand Canyon rebound. And it's Grand Canyon ball. Daniels trying to pass to McDonald, gets knocked out of bounds by the Bronx and will remain with the Lopes. Of course, of note for Grand Canyon, Judy Jones, their leading scorer, Hasn't played a minute. Averages 13.5 points, 8.5 rebounds. Justine Johnson, who normally starts at shooting guard, averaging 8 points per game, hasn't played either. Trying to get their lead back into double figures. They can do that with a basket. And I think Goff stepped out of bounds, so it's going to be Antelope's ball when we return. 42-34 our score with 15:56 to play. You're watching Bronx Basketball.
Here. We understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tack Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. Under 16 minutes to play, and the Bronx lead is 42-34. McDonald misses, rebound, put back, goes. And it's 42-36. Bronx have led in this game by as many as 13. Their lead whittled down to 6. Price trying to find space for a shot. And the whistle is coming the other way, and Coach Tidwell is unhappy. Fifteen to go. Peterson to inbound. Bronx going 3-2. Price adjusts on the inside, trying to guard McDonald, who misses. Rebound by the Bronx. Goff along the left wing. Goes out to Thompson for 3. Got it! Jasmine Thompson from downtown. Bronx are back on the board. It's 45-36. But a quick answer from the left corner from Touchard. And the Bronx lead is back down to 6. Price thought about it. Pass to her left to Goff. Goff tries to come in. Pull-up jumper doesn't go. Thompson tips the rebound, gets it down, puts the pillow on the floor, tries the shot, draws the foul. Thompson's first free throw, round and out. Too much English on it. From the line this season, Thompson a 67% free throw shooter. Second one goes in. Lead is 7. And a whistle. I don't think the shot clock started. Or she wasn't supposed to inbound, perhaps, because they're just going to redo this altogether. Okay. Daniels. Pass out to the right corner. Three from Craig doesn't go. Rebound tipped out of bounds. It's Bronx ball with 13:38 to play, and the Bronx up by 7. Bounds, it'll remain Bronx ball. Whistle's blowing. And the officials want to have a conversation. Inbounding along the baseline, they'll inbound from the sideline, it appears, in front of the scorer's table or in front of the Bronx bench. Price, 7 on the shot clock. Walker, pull up jumper, too strong. Rebound, Grand Canyon. McDonald finds a hoop. 46-41. It's a 5-point game. Bronx once led by 13. Goff answers. 49-41 Bronx. Steal. Goff off to the races. Buyer Lonesome lays it in. And just like that, the Bronx lead is back in double figures. It's 51-41. Fouls on Goff, her second. Elsewhere, the UTPA men's team just underway with Grand Canyon. They're at the first media timeout, and the Bronx are down 8-6. Under 12 minutes to play here. On the corner for Craig. Cycles it out to the top to Peterson. Three on the shot clock. There's the three up. And no good for Touchard. Rebound, Nolan. Fires it ahead to Thompson, lays it in. That's a 7-0 run for UTPA. And it's a 12-point Bronx advantage. McDonald responds. And Grand Canyon calls for a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. Bronx with three players in double figure scoring already. 14 points for Shante Goff. 4 of 9, 2 of 4 from behind the arc. She's got 4 free throws, 3 boards, a block, a steal, 2 assists. Jasmine Thompson has 11 points and 7 rebounds, closing in on a double-double. She's 4 of 5 from the field. Well, you know what? This extends into a media timeout, doesn't it? It's those new rules. My bad. We'll take a break. Be right back.
This commercial brought to you by Lax Furniture, an official sponsor of the University of Texas Pan American Intercollegiate Athletics.
Madness is calling. The 2014 WAC Men's and Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through the 15th at Orleans Arena in Las Vegas. 16 teams battle through the brackets on their way to the Big Dance. Be there to see the big winner.
Ticket packages on sale now at utpabronx.com.
Back we are at the UTPA Fieldhouse in front of a crowd of 748 for this WAC opener. Jonah Goldberg riding with you, 11 minutes to go. Goff misses on the three. Lopes get the rebound. The Bronx lead is 10. And a turnover, McDonald has it. Here come the Lopes. Tip by Nolan, kept by the Lopes. Little floater is well short by Craig. Here come the Bronx with Nolan. Thompson, left wing Goff. Right wing right. And Nolan. Five for Nolan, who blocked by McDonald. She does throw her hand out there. Hard to drive on her. Straya Reed is back in. Madison Craig takes the seat. 4 on the shot clock for the Bronx. Goff inbounds to right. And gets called for a walk. It's Antelopes basketball. 9:59 to go. And McDonald. It's Grand Canyon back within single figures again. Nolan Out on the Broncos logo. Pass to Goff. 8 on the shot clock, 7, 6, 5. Pass to Thompson, gets through her and out of bounds, tipped by Grand Canyon. So it'll be Bronx ball with, again, 4 on the shot clock. Up, looking for the corner, it's picked off, but out of bounds. So we remain Bronx ball. So still 4 on the shot clock. Out of bounds again, and it's still Bronx ball. There's still 4 on the shot clock.
Out of bounds, still.
You figure tenths of a second are coming off. You don't know how many tenths. Now we're back, and it's 3, it's 2. Nolan passes. Walker can't get it off in time. Shot clock violation. It's Lopes basketball. Bronx leading by 8 with 9:10 to go. Out of bounds, and it's still Lopes' ball with 10 on the shot clock. Walker's now got 2. It's only the second on the Bronx. There have only been 5 total fouls in this half. Not that I'm complaining. Bank shot. Estrella Reed. Bronx lead whittled to 6. Lopes have gone as close as 5 in this half. Last time they did that, the Bronx scored the next 7 in a row. Nolan, Thompson, for 3. Too strong. And they're going to call a kick on Grand Canyon. And Pearson pretty much sat on the ball. I guess she kicked it while she was doing so. So Bronx ball. Alexandria Hills back in, replacing Tantra and Nolan. Hills played some strong minutes today. Well, both teams are heading back to their benches. And looks like they're going to go to the replay, perhaps to determine whether or not it was indeed a kickball. In the meantime, we'll give you an update on the men's game at Grand Canyon. There's 11:19 to play in the first half in Phoenix. Bronx and Grand Canyon are tied up at 15 apiece. Bronx led by Shaq Boga. He's got 6 points. Javon Farrell has 3. 2 each for Laurie Toivonen and Justin Leathers and Shaquille Hines. Here, the Bronx with 3 players in double figures, led by Shante Goff with 14, Jasmine Thompson 11, and Alexandra Hill who has 10 points. 2 Lopes in double figures. McDonald has 16 and Peterson with 11. She also has 7 assists, so a chance at a double-double there. Okay, so 15 on the shot clock. After the kickball, 8:14 on the game clock. Bronx up 53-47. And now that everybody's done talking, it looks like we're going to play some basketball. Goff, long inbounds. And as it was bouncing into the backcourt, Alexandria Hill was running for it and committed a foul before anybody could even get to the ball. So it becomes Lopes basketball with 8:14 to play. Donald gets it down low and draws a foul. Jasmine Thompson just picked up her fourth foul. 11.7 rebounds today for Thompson, but four fouls mean she's headed to the bench. Tough blow for UTPA right now. Trying to hold off Grand Canyon. There's a jumper from the foul line. It's good for Peterson. The Bronx lead is cut to four for the first time in this half. Hill. Goff. Back to Hill. Inside to Goff. Now to Price with eight. And Bronx are having trouble finding shots. They're using a lot more time on the shot clock here in the second half than they did in the first. Well, there hasn't been a ton of rhythm here in this second half for anybody, but it's been a tougher half, certainly. Now Goff gets called for a foul. Lopes ball when we return. 7:06 to play, 53-49. Bronx. You're watching Bronx Basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put them somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tax Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tax cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tax Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. The score with 7:06 to play is 53-49 in favor of UTPA. Grand Canyon, though, on an 8-0 run, make it a 9-0 run as Peterson hits the first free throw. One more coming up. It's a one-possession game for the first time in a long time. Last time it was a one-possession game, the Bronx lead was 18-15. That was at the 10:32 mark of the first half. Now it's a two-point game, and it's the first time it's been a two-point game since the Bronx led 6-4. Hill for three. Doesn't go. Offensive rebound, Price. Back out to Hill. Hill's been trying those NBA threes. She's hit two of them today, but she's missed a couple as well, including one there. Walker for three. Doesn't go either. Preston on the rebound gets fouled. Straya Reed picked up her first foul. It's four on Grand Canyon. Quick three, Hill, too strong. Grand Canyon gets the ball back in the midst of a 10-0 run with a chance to tie it or take the lead for the first time since the opening minute of the game. The Lopes led 4-0 out of the gate. The Bronx scored the next 10 and have led ever since. A miss by Peterson. Daniels rebound, no good, but a foul. So Daniels is going to go to the line to try and tie the game.
Personal foul is on number 20, Sherelle Price, her first T6.
Bronx haven't scored in a little over 5 minutes.
At the line is number 45, Deanna Daniels.
Daniels 2-for-2 from the line today. Lopes are 5-of-6, make it 6-of-7. First one's good, it's a 1-point game. And we're tied. 53-53, 6 minutes to go. Here in the first ever whack game for these two teams. 12-0 run over the last 5.5 minutes for Grand Canyon. And this crowd of 748, silent. As Goff misfires. Rebound Lopes, and they could take their first lead since the opening minute of the game with the basket here. Goes out of bounds, the Bronx get the ball back and they can take the lead right back if they can hit a basket here. Jasmine Thompson's back in, Raquel Preston takes a seat, and Thompson playing with four fouls, but you just have to trust that she won't foul out, or if she does, and you gotta hope that she does some positive things first. Because Thompson's had herself a ball game. 11 points and 7 rebounds. Hard to keep her out of the game when it's tied with 5 minutes left. A foul on Sherelle Price on the rebound. That's two on Price, 7 on the Bronx. And that means a 1-and-1 for Jasmine Grayson. Grayson 1-of-2 from the line today. The Lopes are 7-for-8. Grayson hits on the first, and Grand Canyon takes their first lead since it was 4-0. Second shot is good. Bronx trail by 2. Thompson along the baseline. Gives it off to Price. The jumper goes in. Tied at 55.
Price.
4.5 minutes to go. Offensive foul, it's Bronx ball. They can take the lead back right here. got it! Tonasia Walker! And the Bronx have the lead! Four minutes to go. Out of bounds, Bronx ball when we return. 3:57 to play, 58-55 Bronx. This is Bronx basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put him somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tax Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tax cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tax Sales Event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. There's 3:57 on the clock. Buckle your seatbelts. We're in store for quite a finish. The Bronx lead is 58-55. Bronx withstood a 12-0 run, or check that, a 14-0 run by Grand Canyon. They've scored the last five on a jumper by Price and a three-pointer by Walker to tie it and take the lead. 3:45 to go. Alexandria Hill with the basketball in her hands. Pass to the right corner, Walker. Walker for three. Doesn't go. Rebound Daniels. Now Grand Canyon can tie it with a three or pull it within one with a two. Peterson. For three in the tie. Misses. Offensive board. McDonald misses. Wave off that last shot attempt, that would have been good. Foul on the floor. 1-1 coming up for Grand Canyon.
Personal foul is on number one, Jasmine Thompson. Her fifth, she has fouled out.
Jasmine Thompson just fouled out of the game.
Foul in the half.
So Raquel Preston's gonna come in. Thompson finishes the game with 11 points and 7 rebounds. She went 4 of 6 from the field, 2 of 3 from beyond the arc, 1 of 2 from the line, and had an assist as well. First free throw good. Second shot goes. 58-57, 3:15 to go. Hill, the Price at the top. There's Goff for three. Off the back iron, Price, the offensive board. Takes it out to the corner. Pass over to Goff. 3 minutes even on the clock. Hill with a big smile on her face, dribbling it out. 15 on the shot clock, left wing Goff. Whistle away from the ball. Sherelle Price called for an offensive board. It's her third, or offensive foul, I should say. Bronx with nine. 2:50 to go. And the Lopes can take the lead here. Daniels, high right elbow. Left wing Peterson alone for three, wave it off. Offensive foul. McDonald the culprit. Her third. It's only her first foul of the second half. Got too early in the first half and really didn't play in the first half. She's been out there for almost every minute of the second half. And she stayed out of further foul trouble. And it certainly made a difference. So we've got a one-point game with 2:15 to go. Hill, an NBA three. Doesn't go. Rebound, Lopes. One of the dangers of having the NBA line down is it's tempting. How can it not be? Minute 58 to go. A turnover makes it Bronx ball. Up one. The reason the NBA line is down is there's a local D-League team that is practicing here this year. Hill, left corner, Goff. Spin around, jumper, doesn't go. Rebound by Walker, she got fouled. Jump ball. Tried going up for the shot, now possession arrow does favor the Bronx. This was all ball. 29 on the shot clock. Lob out to Price with a minute 32 to go. Bronx by one. Middle of the right wing, Goff. Goff at the foul line. Bounce out to Price for three. Too strong. Rebound McDonald with a minute 14 to go. The Lopes can take the lead here. Bronx need a stop. Bronx playing aggressive man-to-man. Price swats it away, picks it up. That's a steal. Now Hill has the ball. 50 on the game clock, 23 on the shot clock. Up by one. Coach Tidwell gives out the instructions. Hill to her left with 11, with 10. Coming in, gets fouled. 36.8 ticks of the clock remaining. And Alexandria Hill is headed to the line for two shots. Hill 2 of 2 from the line today. She's 6 for 6 this season. Nothing but net. That's a 2-point game. It's a 3-point game. 60-57, and a timeout called for by UTPA. It's a 30-second timeout, and this gives the Bronx a chance to set up their defense and then draw up a play. When they get the ball back, because there are a few possibilities that can happen here. I guess Grand Canyon thinks that it was a full timeout because their players have chosen to sit down, which you aren't supposed to do when it's a 30. Grand Canyon draws up an offensive play to try and score. They have a few options here. They could go for a quick two. You don't have to go for three yet. There's a lot of time left. You can go for it all. Grand Canyon 4-14 from behind the arc, but 3 of 6 here in the second half. After going 1 of 8 in the first. Peterson with the ball. Bronx playing full court press. And it takes 8 seconds, but Grand Canyon does get it through. McDonald misses. She gets fouled. Not the worst thing in the world, though, because you can't tie it on free throws. 25.1 seconds left. Hill picks up her third foul. Bronx over the limit. McDonald's making her first trip to the line today. First one's good. McDonald is now 6 of 12 from the line this season. Crowd getting loud. Off the back iron, rebound, tipped and grabbed by the Bronx. Walker's got it with the shot clock off. Hands it off to Hill. Dribbling it up past half court and she gets fouled and reaching by Touchard. With 17.6 seconds left, Hill's going to line to try and make this a two-possession game. And that's four on Touchard. Eight. Ooh, that is eight on Grand Canyon. So Hill gets a one and one. She misses her first free throw of the year. Now Grand Canyon gets the ball. With a chance to tie it or win it with the shot clock off. And the Antelopes call for timeout. 15 seconds left. Bronx are over the limit in fouls, so they really need to avoid fouling, as if they do. And Grand Canyon will have a chance to tie it without the clock moving. Just need a stop. Simple as that. 15 seconds left. Inbounds directly in front of us. And the chance of defense growing in intensity with 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. For the win, it's partially deflected. For the tie, it doesn't go. 1 second left. There's the buzzer! Bronx win! Bronx win! Bronx win! The Bronx take their whack opener 60-58. Well, it was certainly an intense finish. But you take them as they come. As the Bronx escape with a 60-58 victory over Grand Canyon. Wow. So the Bronx win their first ever WAC basketball game. And they knock off the 25th ranked team in mid-major in the country. In 11 and 2 Grand Canyon. We are going to take a look at some of these final numbers, and coming up on Bronx postgame, we'll also be joined by Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell. Right after the game ends, as you probably saw some of the players behind me, they always like to go into the stands and thank the fans for coming out to the game. Coach Tidwell, no different. And then they'll go into the locker room and talk about the game afterwards. So we'll take a look at some of the final numbers first, and we will start with visiting Grand Canyon. Leading the Lopes in scoring with 17 points, Asha McDonald on 8 of 13 shooting. 8 rebounds and 5 blocks as well. 15 points for Caitlin Peterson, 6 of 11 shooting. 1 of 4 from behind the arc. 2 of 2 from the line with 2 rebounds and 7 assists. Also had a steal. Everybody else in single figures for the Lopes. 8 points, 9 rebounds for Deanna Daniels. 2 steals, 2 assists. 6 points, 3 rebounds for August Touchard. 5 points for Jasmine Grayson. 4 for Estrella Reed and 3 for Madison Craig. Antelopes, 21 of 52 from the field, that's 40%. 4 of 14 from behind the arc, 29%. And 12 of 14 from the line, That is 86%. 31 rebounds, 11 offensive compared to 39 and 18 for UTPA. The Bronx led in scoring. Four players reached double figures. Shante Goff on top of everybody with 14 points. 4 of 13 shooting, 2 of 6 from behind the arc, a perfect 4 of 4 from the line. 4 rebounds, 3 assists, a block, and a steal. 12 points for Alexandria Hill, 3 of 9 shooting, 2 of 7 from behind the arc, 4 for 5 from the line, a rebound, an assist, and 2 steals. 11 points, Jasmine Thompson, 4 of 6 from the field, 2 of 3 from behind the arc, 1 of 2 from the line, 7 boards, and an assist. 10 points, Sherelle Price, 4 of 11 shooting, 2 of 6 from behind the arc, 4 rebounds, an assist, and a steal. After that, 9 points for Tanisha Walker with 3 boards, 2 points for Raquel Preston, 5 rebounds, 2 points, 3 rebounds, Shazay Wright. The Bronx, 19 of 56 from the field, that's 34%. 9 of 28 from behind the arc, 32%. And 13 for 16 from the line, that's 81%. Points in the paint, Grand Canyon with 20, UTPA with 10. Points off turnovers, the Lopes with 18 points off of 21 Bronx turnovers. The Bronx, 22 points off of 21 Grand Canyon turnovers. Lopes with 12 second chance points, the Bronx with 5. Bronx with 6 fast break points, the Lopes with none. Bench points were about even, 16 for the Bronx, 14 for the Lopes. There were 3 lead changes and 2 ties. We give you all these numbers, but the only ones that matter, 60-58, the Bronx defeat Grand Canyon in the first WAC basketball game in school history. The Bronx improved to 7-7. They're back at 500. 1-0 in WAC play, which means they'll be tied for first place with Idaho and Seattle. Grand Canyon falls to 11-3, 0-1 in WAC play. By the way, I mentioned they're tied for first place with Idaho and Seattle. You want to guess who the Bronx next 2 WAC opponents are? Come on, guess. Yeah, it's Idaho a week from today, and then Seattle a week from Saturday, both of those games on the road. We'll have links to the live broadcast and live stats up on utpabronx.com for both of those games. And the reason that they'll be tied with Seattle and Idaho is Seattle beat Chicago State 85-58. And Idaho beat UMKC, or is beating UMKC 71-53. That game should be over by now. Let me refresh on the stats. Yeah, there's 8 seconds left. It's 81-64 Idaho. So the Bronx, one of 3 1-0 teams at the end of the day.
Hey, Renee Garza.
Yes, sir.
Did you hear that play? I called Garza. It didn't work one time.
And Coach Tidwell still working his way through folks. So, yeah, we'll take a quick timeout. And when he is ready to talk, we will come right back. Bronx win 60-58. This is Bronx basketball.
Here, we understand how a team is the result of being part of something larger than yourself. Creating a better outcome and a better tomorrow. Doctors Hospital Renaissance is proud to support the University of Texas Pan-American Bronx.
Dr. Pena, does LASIK surgery work?
LASIK surgery is America's most frequently performed elective procedure. In fact, I've helped thousands of patients see better.
Dr. Pena.
Call me Raulito.
Thousands and thousands. Raulito, are you sure?
Is that thing on?
Yes.
Follow me. I had to put them somewhere. It's a big project.
That's a lot of successful operations. Call Dr. Raulito Pena at 661-UC.
The phone keeps ringing. Gotta make room.
It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC. Come in today and claim your Red Tack cash on just about all of our Buick and GMC inventory. It's the Red Tack Sales event at South Texas Buick GMC.
Not the biggest, just the best.
Welcome back out to the UTPA Fieldhouse. Jonah Goldberg riding with you. Final score is 60-58 in favor of the Bronx. They win their WAC opener. We're now joined by Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell. And coach, a little bit of a heart-pumping finish, huh?
Well, I tell you, you know, we just got to shoot the ball better. I mean, we have shots and we don't finish at the rim, but, you know, they fought so hard. And then we hit some big shots, and I got to give credit. You know, Sherrell Price hit some big ones. JT played really hard. Shantae Goff, Walker. Allie Hill came off the bench, scored 12 points. I mean, Tanisha Walker, tenacious defense. We got good effort from everybody.
What does it mean to get that win in this first WAC game?
Well, it means that we're 7-7, one. That means we're fighting above, staying at 500. But to win the first game ever in the WAC for UTPA, that's a great feeling. That's a great feeling. And there's so many people that work so hard, our president, our board of regents, Chris King, to work so hard to get us in a conference. They went without a conference for 15 years, Jonah, and it's amazing. I have so much respect for the players and the coaches who coached here when you didn't have a conference. That's incredible. And so I really appreciate what they did in the past, and we're just trying to build for the future.
Well, Coach, well, thanks a lot, and congratulations.
Good win. Good win.
Bronx head coach Larry Tidwell. Bronx pick up the 60-58 victory over Grand Canyon to improve to 1-0 and be tied for first place in the WAC standings. Bronx are back in action a week from today at 7 o'clock when they visit the Idaho Vandals for the first time in program history. So watch the game. To get your live stats, check out utpabronx.com. But that'll do it for us from the UTPA Fieldhouse. I thank everybody out there for tuning in. This has been a presentation of Bronx Basketball. For more information, you can log on to utpabronx.com. If you'd ever like to reach us, send an email. Contact info is up on the website under Inside Athletics. Click on Staff Directory. But for now, for Jim Bob Sides in the control room and the entire camera crew, this is Jonah Goldberg saying good night from the UTPA Fieldhouse. Bronx win 60-58.